Just imagine when those militias comes to the families, those are the testimony we get, they will rape and murder in front of their children, in front of their husband. Some of the women will even be taken from their family. They'll bring them to the woods for 1 week, 2 weeks perhaps. They would rape her up until the point they feel she's not able to take it anymore. Then they would return the person back to her family, completely destroyed. And that's what has been going on in Congo, financed by those mineral corporations. They use children underage as slaves in the mining field.
As far as we could see, hundreds of children and teenagers were mining for gold with their bare hands. Many of the children here were child soldiers, forced to fight on behalf of militia groups during the war. 21-year-old Samuel has been mining here for the past 8 years. Twelve-year-old Pepito began fighting for the militia when he was six.
Ils creusent nus, d'abord, ils ne sont pas protégés. Ils utilisent des torches simples qu'on achète au marché ici, des torches de deux piles. Hein. Ils ne sont pas protégés, les mains sont nues. Et ils utilisent des birins avec des marteaux. Et il y a des éboulements. Il y en a qui meurent là-dedans. Ah, il y a aussi la respiration. Il n'y a pas d'air dedans. Alors, ce sont des conditions inimaginables.
Oui, vous avez un
The second thing is they use armed groups, mercenaries, different military groups, so that they can take controls of the regions. Their mining corporation, they're all using mercenaries, militias groups. Those people are drugs, and they get to villages, they kill people as cockroaches.
Since 1998, nearly 4 million people have died, more than any other conflict since World War II.
Par rapport au marché du coltan ou même de l'or, il faut se poser la question de savoir à qui a profité le commerce. Là, je dirais carrément que c'est aux multinationales.
Tout ce que nous savons ici, c'est que les gens savent ici que tout ce qui s'est passé, c'est sous influence de la communauté internationale.
Face those names, names of corporations, names of leaders who have been officially elected by Canadians, who are using Canada to promote their own business. They're here, we are in Canada, we pay our taxes, and we don't want Canadian pension plan funds to be invested toward those corporations who are violating human rights and who are even destroying the environmental, not only here in Canada, but in Africa, Latin America, and many different places.
Si on s'en tient à ce que coûte un téléphone ou un ordinateur par rapport à ce que gagne quelqu'un qui produit le coltan, on va se rendre compte qu'il y a un très très grand écart.
Buying shares to those companies, you're basically financing human rights violations. Women who have been raped could be your mother, could be your grandmother. Children who have been raped could be your son, your daughters, and so on. So it doesn't matter whether it's done in Congo or Colombia, Argentina. We're talking about the human right. Human right means no one should die for a company to make money.